going through some of my makeup and stuff, and I found all this old foundation. I know. But I found this old foundation that I used to use when I first started doing makeup. And I was thinking, I was like, oh, you know, maybe I should try these things out. Because there's still, like, makeup in it. I was like, oh, let me try them out and see if, like, I like them, if I want to buy more of it. So it's mostly drugstore stuff. So, yeah. Right now, I'm just going to, I already put primer on and everything. So right now, I'm going to go with Maybelline. Hope you guys can, you probably can't see it. But it's Maybelline, I guess concealer. It's in my skin tone. Which is a cafe. And it's number 30 by Fit Me. So I'm going to go in with that. I used to use this all the time back in the day. This is like my thing. I used to buy like tubes of this. And this is like my base foundation. And then I would add like 20 other layers to that. So I'm literally just going to like smother my face in it. Yeah, get in there, get in my pores. Oh yeah, I know I'm like covering up my other mole, but such is life. As you guys can see, I'm just slabbing it on there. Because it really doesn't matter how you put it on. You just gotta get it on there. And there's just like, so little in there. So I'll definitely be purchasing another one of these. I do use it. When I do find it, I use it. So this one is done. Let me get my beauty blender. And real hair. It's a great arm exercise. Love it. My arms are already burning. I'm like, why? I apologize beforehand because my makeup's kind of sloppy. I didn't think doing my makeup on camera would take so damn long. But it does, actually. But it does. So, yeah. Especially those of you who, like, do everything by yourself on your camera. Yeah, no, I don't do that. Alright, that's mostly blended in. Mostly. I'm gonna go in with Cinema Secrets foundation. It's Ultimate Foundation. What color are you? I don't know what color this is, but it looks like this. It has CS on it for Cinema Secrets. Yeah, when you go in there, you can just ask them to color match you or whatever. I got the smallest thing they had because I'm cheap. And it was, I think this one was like 20 something and the other one was like 40. I'm like, oh god, no. So I'm just gonna go in with that. Used to use this all the time back in the day. As you guys can see, it has like a little hole in it. Yeah, real stuff, man, real stuff. It's already hit pan, so poor thing. I don't know where my foundation brush is. It's somewhere hiding. I would use my nail, but you know when you guys have acrylics, like, everything gets in your nails. So I'm trying to avoid that with my life, but I'm just gonna literally pile this on. Like, there's no tomorrow. I will probably end up going back to Cinema Secrets and getting another one of these. I only got this one because there was one similar to this one, Benai, but I couldn't afford it at the time. So that's why I have Cinema Secrets. I'll just go back and get both. I'm trying to use, like, as much as I possibly can. I keep, like, digging and digging and digging. Alright. That's done. Let's move on from that. Okay. First foundation I'm gonna do is L'Oreal by L'Oreal Paris Visible Lift Blur Foundation. The color is 212 Classic Tan. Yeah. Oh. As you guys can see, this is, when I tell you it's old foundation, it is old. It's at least two years old. I know. No. There's like gloss that on there. I know. I'm going to get my neck in a little bit, guys. Because it's the most important thing. Especially if you're someone of my size. Getting your neck is literally It does wonders. You don't understand when your face is like this color and then your neck's like, what happened? So yeah, super. I don't know if I like this one. I remember when I got it, there's something about it that I was like, eh. Huh? I know this looks like a lot of foundation. Really not. I used to do like 20 layers back in the day. This is nothing. Alright, that's done for that one. I don't know if I want to get another. Feels fine. Ooh! L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation. This is N78 Classic Tan / Cappuccino. That's what it is. It's Cappuccino. So it looks like that. I like it because it has a pump. So I've bought a few of these in the day. And again, I'm just going to get the neck. And you don't even go to the drugstore, like, drugstore foundation's, like, not even cheap anymore. It's, like, actually getting pretty pricey. Put some on my forehead. I know, right? This looks like a lot, but it's really not. In the grand scheme, it's really, really, really not. Smother that on there. Don't forget my ears. I have another ear. I always put foundation on my lips. Or just something I do. Oh, crease it on my nose. Crease it on my nose. Alright, that one's done. I will pick up another one of these. I actually really do like it. Okay, I like Revlon because I like Halle Berry. If you guys have watched any of my videos, you guys probably know that I'm obsessed with this woman. So when she was on the commercials, like, Revlon. So I bought the Revlon Photo Ready Airbrush Effect. It's in number 10, Caramel. It's in this little, pretty little bottle. Yeah, pretty. Apparently my hands aren't working today. There you go. And also comes in pump, which, no, I like. And I'm seriously doing like a throwback, because this is how I used to always do my makeup. And sometimes I still do my makeup like this. I just slap it on there, put a whole bunch of powder on it, and be like, what the? So, I don't know if I like this one. When I first started buying makeup and stuff and like foundation, I have really oily skin. Like, I will look like at the end of the day, like I've been frying fried chicken all day long. I just have grease all over me. So buying foundation, I didn't know that there's foundation for oil. Oily skin, combination skin, and so forth and so on. So I was just getting whatever. And then I'd be like, why does my skin look like that? And now I'm like, makes sense. Sometimes I still don't care, but now I'm more aware of what I put on my face, because it's not cute when you go to work and then you're like, you're looking cute for like 2 hours, and then the grease just starts to like pool on your pores, and you're like, oh god. You know, and then no one tells you at work. No one tells you that you need a blur. No one tells you. I don't think I'll ever repurchase this again, so that can go in the trash pile. One more foundation, I promise, guys. It's Maybelline Dream Liquid Mousse Airbrush Finish. I was really into airbrush back then. Yeah. It's Caramel Dark Number 2. Okay. Here we go. Hey guys, okay, so new batteries in. Okay, so now that I put on like layers of foundation, I'm gonna go in with Benai Neutral Set. Back in the day, I used Benai. I've always been a Benai fan. I'm like, I love them, obsessed with them. But I didn't use the white one, I used the colored one. And then I realized if I got on my clothes, it would totally stain my clothes. And then my mom was like, hey, you know, they have like a white one. I was like, what? So now I use the white one. Literally just gonna put this in my hand. I really need to buy another one. I'm a little too generous with this. I'm gonna put it everywhere. Just get in these nooks and crannies. Do you see this? You're gonna get in it. just scoop it. You're going to literally take it from your hand, scoop it, and just, like, ram it in there. I literally use every last drop. And then I'm gonna just dab it in. Alright, it looks less greasy. I think when you put so many foundations on like I do, sometimes I go hard or go home and just put like all the foundation in the world, and then I have to put all the powder in the world. Let me grab my neck. When you're someone of my size, make sure you get your neck, okay? Yeah, make sure you get your neck and your rolls and everything. All right guys, that's done. I'm gonna go in with a Morphe brush. I don't know what number it is or any of that fun stuff. It's a Morphe brush. Looks like this. Yeah. I really used to be obsessed with Maybelline foundation. So I have the Fit Me Maybelline 360 Press Powder. It's called Mocha. They don't have this one anymore. I've tried looking for it because I actually really like it as a contouring. I can't find it. So I don't know what happened. But as you guys can see, I've literally used this so many times, and I always hit pan. I literally, that's the type of person I am. When I use something, I just hit pan. Yeah. So I'm just gonna go in right here and just put it everywhere. That one is a done. If I could find this one, I totally would buy it again, but I've looked for it and maybe not looking hard enough, I can't find it. This one is by CoverGirl Queen Latifah. Love it, love it, love it. This one's called Q120 Ebony Bronze. Love this one. Just gonna go in my cheeks, forehead, and I'm gonna take my neck. Go in here. Go in here. I'm gonna take. Ooh, I have an Inglot brush. Ooh, I feel all kinds of fancy today. It's 6SS Inglot brush. Yeah. So I'm gonna go in there. I'm gonna take this powder and get on my nouser. So I'm gonna literally, as you guys can see, I'm not paying attention if it's a lot of makeup. You can always go in and fix it. Oh my god. And then there you go for that one. I've actually bought several of these. This one is the CoverGirl Queen Latifah Q 425 medium deep. That's what it looks like. It's pretty awesome. I'm gonna go in there with this. It for those. I love those powders, they're my favorites. I'm actually gonna go in with this Revlon. Yeah, I'm obsessed. I told you I was obsessed with Revlon back in the day. Age defying concealer. It looks like this. Hopefully you guys can see it. Yeah, I haven't. I remember when I bought it, I thought I was getting wrinkles and stuff, and I was like, oh, this is gonna help me with my wrinkles. It just turned out I have really big pores. Since my cheeks are really big, I'm just gonna try and do like a, I don't really know how to explain it, but like a V, I guess. Yeah. I don't think I'm gonna buy another one of these. I think I'm gonna buy a Maybelline one. And then we're going for here. There's not much left of here. You know what? I really hope I have another. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and use Maybelline. I have a Maybelline one that's like pretty much the same color that I have on my face right now. Just more in it. Get in my nose. That area. And that. I look ridiculous right now. I look like I'm in some type of tribe or something. Oh my god. Alright. Almost done, guys. Oh my god. Alright, go back in with some more banana. Go back in there. I did not think doing my makeup on camera was gonna be this difficult, but apparently it is. No, I think this is gonna be the one and only tutorial I ever do. Ever. I'm gonna go in with a big brush. I'm just gonna blend everything. Because I'm getting tired. Mind you guys, I swear, usually when I do my makeup, it's more precise, but. Alright, I'm gonna go in with Lancome pressed powder. It's 510 suede. Yeah. Oh. Oh, and you can find this one at Macy's. It's, I don't know how much it is, but yeah. When I found it, I was like, oh my god, it covers actually really, really well. That's what I like about it. So, that's always fun. Okay, so, no, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest of my makeup, and then I'll be right back, okay? Bye. Hey guys, okay, so the saga still continues with me trying to do my makeup. So I've gotten color back in my face, I've done my blush, pretty much for my blush, I used to buy a lot of NYX cosmetics, because they're really inexpensive, and they actually are really nice and pigmented. So I have this one NYX that I've had forever and ever and ever. It's PB24 Red. It's really not that red. When I bought it, I was like, oh, it's so cute. It's more of a pink, so it's not really a red. And I think it was only like $4 when I bought it. I have this Benai palette, and literally the struggle's real. Sorry. I used this pink, and then I used this one, and then this one. So that's what's on my cheeks. It actually has the colors on the back. I'm so dumb. Anyways, so I'm gonna do my lip color. It's either Stella or Stila. I call it Stella, whatever. Stay All Day Liquid Lipstick. it's called Patina. Patina. Sorry if I butchered it. Okay, let's just wait. my bad. I'm gonna go in with the MAC pencil. It's called Cherry. Just gonna line my lips. I probably should have a different color, but this seems like a cute idea. Bear with me. I have an idea. And I'm not the best at lining my lips. I have to make it perfect? Like half of it's on my lip, half of it's not. That's done. Okay. First, I'm going to go in with LA Girl. Matte lipstick. It's called Electric. This is what it looks like. Okay. I'm going to go with that. You know, the one thing I really need to practice more is like lining my lips perfectly. I don't look like a dodo brain all the time. So I'm just gonna put it on there. I'm gonna put it on here and then I'm gonna tap it in before it dries. I think that looks okay. Kinda like it. See, this is the problem with my life. If anyone has acrylics, you understand when you do your makeup, it like just, I have makeup all over my acrylics. Everywhere, guys, everywhere, okay? It's just a problem in my life. Thank God I got gel, because I was just, anyways. I think that's kind of it. Let me just clean that up. Oh, I kind of today. Yeah, that's my makeup. Yeah, I'm gonna link everything, and yeah, it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be great. I think one thing I do want to mention, oh yeah, what's on my eyes, I'll link it below, but mostly it's Benai, and then cause I loved this Benai gold back in the day. NYX, Lancome, I loved a lot of Lancome back then. And then what else was the biggest thing? It was like some pot thing. Somewhere, guys, somewhere. I don't know, it's somewhere here in the mess of all this makeup. Oh, sorry. It's the tattoo, color tattoo metal by iStudio. This color, I love this color so much. Just so cute, so pigmented, so gold, love it. So that was the main inspiration for everything. I saw it today and I was like, oh, you know, let me use it. And yeah, that's about it. So thanks guys, bye.